couples who think they have what it takes to throw the perfect dinner party.
Ta-da!
Ah! Lovely jubbly.
And get them to score each other in secret. Today, romantic gestures.
You are my sunshine.
I just find it a bit irritating. I mean, I just think...
And an outrageous outburst.
Even the smell of it makes me gag.
I think Joy definitely a massive drama queen.
I was starting to feel upset myself.
As the couples compete for a £1,000 prize.
You look wonderful tonight.
Today's couples come dine with me in St. Albans, home to Chiliquy goat's cheese, served at the wedding of Prince William and Kate, no less. And hoping for a ripe royal knees-up of their own is the first of today's three couples, legal administrator Joy and her hubby of 13 years, gardener Jerry.
Don't cut too much off that.
Do you want to do it?
Whatever. I like things all organised and everything at neat. He's happy to let me just do it and get on with it. So if that means I wear the trousers, well, that means I wear the trousers.
It sounds as though I don't put a lot into it, but I do, but I can't think offhand what I do.
Well, Jerry, perhaps today is your chance to prove yourself, beginning with the starter, twice-baked Swiss cheese souffle.
I'm not a massive fan of cheese, to be honest.
No,
but,
you won't eat it.
I might eat it. I'll tell him as well.
All right, here we go.
Meet today's second couple, children's entertainer Ricky and girlfriend of nearly 4 years, student Becca.
We do cuddle and smooch.
Yeah, we are very affectionate and romantic.
But
look at her.
Look at us.
And cooking together is going to be an experience for them both.
We don't live together, so it'll be our first dinner party.
Yeah, and see if we can actually do good together.
If it's a success,
might
move in together.
What?
awkward. Back with our first hosts, and it's on with the souffle. Joy makes a roux with butter, flour, milk, and egg yolks.
Can I mix it?
No.
Why not?
Because you can't. You can't do this.
I can.
Next in is the grated cheese.
See, I could do that, couldn't I?
Oh, for God's sake, bloody do it.
Look at that. I've done it so much better than you.
Careful, Jerry.
Is that the one that if you open the oven door, it goes all...
It could, like that, collapse. So I think that it's a very ambitious starter.
Is it ambitious or are they just so much better than us?
We'll see, won't we?
Completing our lineup, Fire Brigade Watch Manager Sian and her retired firefighter and music-loving husband, Tim.
When I met you, I didn't know your name.
I'm the hopeless romantic.
And I'm not.
Sian isn't.
No, we're not an amorous couple, in short. But we love each other.
Yeah, we hold hands in public.
Yeah, occasionally. But we're not touchy-feely.
We're not snoggers.
You know, cuddling up on the sofa all the time. You can see me, I'm prickling at the thought of it, sort of thing. But
jolly good. Back to the souffle, I think. Joy adds whisked egg whites to the mix.
No, you can't do this bit.
And after ladling into grease-lined tins, they're into the oven. They'll be baked for a second time just before serving. Next, they're cooking the main, and inspired by their travels stateside, it's Cajun jambalaya with a mystery side.
Sounds colourful and interesting and spicy and delicious.
I actually got the recipe from a chef when we were in Louisiana. We had it and I loved it so much that I asked him for the recipe.
Joy fries off a mix of onions, peppers, celery, mushrooms and tomatoes, whilst Jerry chops up the chicken under Joy's ever watchful eye.
Make sure you cut every bit of gristle.
The prawns, chicken and sausage are flavoured with Joy's homemade Creole seasoning.
I think we work great as a team because he knows his place. As all men should.
I'm not even going to answer that.
Because you know your place. On to the mystery side.
Who puts a mystery side?
It's from the swamps. We've actually eaten it ourselves in Louisiana. And tonight the mystery food will be alligator.
Oh, how very continental. Joy pops the alligator into buttermilk to deep fry later tonight. Last up, dessert, raspberry and kiwi fruit pavlova.
That's meringue, isn't it?
Yes.
And I do not like meringue.
Slice them, but not too thick slices. Well, just do one and let me see it.
Yeah, Jerry, do one. While he chops the kiwis, Joy assembles the pavlovas using homemade meringues. Gooey, Joy!
Do you want to stand there holding it? obviously.
Yeah. Joy!
Oh, it's getting heavy. Put them on the side there, off like that.
All right, steady on, both of you.
Pushing me around.
Once the kiwis are eventually on, the pavlova is complete. And there's just time for a quick change before the first guests arrive.
All ready?
It's lovebirds Ricky and Becca.
Hello. Hello.
Okay. Oh, we're in.
Hiya, I'm Joy.
I'm Ricky. I'll give us a love.
Well, hello. Hello, nice to meet you.
You're Becca. You're Becca and Rick.
Ricky.
Please,
very
please
good.
Go in. Come
on. Yeah, she seems really nice. She seems a fun character. She's going to be a lot of fun during the next couple of days.
Yeah, or she could be mental.
They are really young. God, they're younger than my kids.
All right.
I hope I haven't got to play mummy.
Next in, it's Sian and Tim.
Hiya!
Hello!
Come in!
I'm Joy.
Hi, Joy, I'm Sian. Nice
please
to you.
Go in, please go in.
Hi, I'm Tim.
Hi, I'm Tim, Joy. I'm Joy.
Yeah, two good yeah, cheers. Good couple of daddies.
Coming up, loose tongues.
Anyone can make that up.
Yeah.
No, we can all do that. I can be a clown, I can do this. I can
What did she say? I don't mean to be offensive, but anyone could do what you do for a living.
And fragrant surprises.
That's so spicy.
Night one in St. Albans.
Yeah.
Where the first of our three couples, Joy and Jerry, are hoping to host their way to a grand.
Oh, look at these little darlings, Jerry.
Hold on. So...
They're a bit dark on top, but I don't think that'll be a problem. No, I don't think they're burnt.
Well, your guests will be the judge of that. It's twice-baked cheese souffle.
Please tuck in. Well, lovely.
So who made this then? Who was the...
I make the cheese souffle.
Oh, do you?
I've made this a lot of times and we haven't yet come across somebody that doesn't like it.
No.
The only thing is, if...
There's always a first time.
If somebody doesn't like cheese, then I'm scuffed, don't I?
Brace yourself, Joy.
I'm not a massive fan of cheese.
Oh, it is. It is quite cheese.
But, yeah, but like, I've eaten most of it.
This is... outstanding. Love it.
I'm so pleased to enjoy that.
The cheese souffle was outstanding and technically difficult, so I'm very, very impressed.
My first taste of cheese souffle, and I am really impressed.
For you, dear.
Don't even mind it. It was
that's
so
good.
I did actually take your plate and...
finish it.
Scooch onto mine, but, yeah, I liked it.
Because we finish each other's...
sentences.
Food.
Oh! At the table, Jerry's got a question.
How did you meet Sian?
Sian's in her 30th year as a firefighter. She joined before me. She joined.
Oh, you're in the fire brigade.
Good
yeah,
done,
brilliant.
You.
Oh,
well done.
What do you do then, Jerry?
I'm a landscape gardener.
So how did you two meet then? Different did he come and do your garden?
He was my gardener.
No.
Amazing.
Is that what's that desperate housewife?
A desperate housewife.
Did you have your shirt off when you were just like mowing the lawn?
Oh, yes, I did. That's right, yeah.
Brilliant. Yeah. I can just imagine him in the summer with his top off.
Yeah.
20 years ago. And she's just in the kitchen. Would you like some coffee, Jerry? Not that she's been. Would you like some coffee, Jerry?
That's more like it.
Becca, how long have you been together then?
3.5 years.
4 years in September.
Travelled?
So. Oh, I'm counting.
September 17th.
There's sort of chemistry going on. Oh,
we have that excitement in our relationship. Yeah. And, like, I don't think that will ever end.
I do think there's a magic there, and it's lovely.
What did you say you did for a living?
You didn't, did you?
No.
You kept that quiet.
I run an entertainment company.
You're
so
a clown.
We do.
What?
Pretty much.
I was going to say that.
So I do a lot of children's entertaining.
I do.
And that's kind of most of it.
No, I did think of something. No. And I thought, I can't, it's too rude.
I'm Captain Fantastic.
Have you got a costume?
There is a costume, yeah, but I don't tend to wear it that much.
You want it tonight?
I'm not a clown. There is a difference between a children's entertainer and a clown.
Yeah, right.
Time to get on with the main. Joy adds rice, chicken and prawns to a prepared jambalaya mix, whilst Jerry is left in charge of the dip.
How hard is it to put a dip in a bowl?
Next, Joy deep fries her alligator bites and serves Cajun jambalaya with a mystery side. I wonder if they've got any ideas.
My first guess from that would be scorpion.
Wrong.
Is it regional? Is it local?
It's local to Louisiana.
Yeah.
Is it an alligator?
Yes!
Yay! Yay! Right, everybody, have a go at the old alligator.
Mmm, really tasty. It tasted a bit like a chicken nugget.
Maybe it was.
Maybe it was, they just fancied it up a little.
Yeah.
I think the main is delicious. I've had jambalaya once, but I can't remember what airport I was at, but it was nowhere near as nice as this.
It had real flavour, it was plenty of it, so you felt like you had a really good old feed, which is what we like.
Who did what? Did you make any of this, Jerry?
25%.
Yeah, 25-30%. I did all the cutting and slicing and stuff
sous-chef
like that. Yeah, sous chef.
I think Joy loves just being in charge, and I think Jerry likes that as well. It's nice to have a woman take care of you. They could take note.
Whoa.
And Ricky's career is still on Joy's mind.
When you sort of say a children's entertainer, I'm not putting you down.
Oh, yeah,
Not for any... But you think, well, you know, anyone can make that up.
Yeah.
You know, we can all do that. I can be a clown, I can do this, I can
What does she say? I don't mean to be offensive, but anyone could do what you do for a living.
I feel like Joy maybe has an answer to everything. She does like to rival things up a bit.
Maybe dessert will cool things down. Raspberry and kiwi fruit pavlova and a sparkler.
I'm not a massive pavlova fan, but this is awesome. Now, this is really nice, you know.
This is absolutely my favourite dessert, and it is done to perfection. Really delicious.
Thank you so much.
Well, you can fight over mine if you want a little bit.
Yeah, we will. Okay. Knives at dawn or arm wrestling?
Arm wrestling.
Or juggling? You do juggling?
He's not a clown!
No.
What sort of superhero doesn't do juggling?
No superhero does juggling.
Juggling man does.
I am not a clown.
I love the fruit, I love the cream, I love the combination, so yeah, great.
I think we've got the competition in the bag.
We'll see about that. Scores are out of 20.
We are going to give Joy and Jerry a 14.
And we're going to give Joy and Jerry's wonderful night an 18 because we really couldn't fault it. There was everything and the food was fantastic. We agree?
Yes.
Thanks, Tim. So Joy and Jerry are off to a snappy start with an impressive 32 out of 40. It's day two and we're now in North London, where it's the turn of our second couple to host. Dinner party rookies, Ricky and Becca.
Well, this is going to be our first dinner party, cooking for people and, yeah, never done it before.
Properly cooking for people tonight, yeah.
And they're not the only two who are worrying about tonight.
We wonder how Becca will cope with Ricky in the kitchen because he is so bouncy and I wonder if he'll just be all over the place.
They're young and in love, they'll be fine.
You think so?
No phasing at all there.
Yeah, it's the romantic in
you. They were breaking to kiss each other every 10 minutes last night.
Yeah, we'll never get any food.
A sentiment echoed by last night's hosts, Joy and Jerry. What a tiny dog!
I think they're sort of in the first throes of their sort of relationship and they're into each other big time and it's like can't keep their hands off each other.
Well, Ricky and Becca will need to free up their hands to make dessert. Vanilla panna cotta.
If they're going to make that from scratch, that sounds complicated.
Light panna cotta. It's very easy to make, though. Very easy to make.
Didn't you make pavlova? They start by adding whole milk, double cream, sugar and vanilla pod seeds to a pan and bringing it to the boil.
Whoa, turn it down.
Turn it off.
You haven't.
Turn it off.
Jeez, Ricky.
What? I said turn it off.
We leave this for 10 minutes to...
We'll leave it then. To infuse. We need to infuse it.
All right.
Calm down.
Yeah, well, you're getting annoying.
Calm down.
Where's the loft gone? Some gelatin is added, and for the final touch, the mix is put into heart-shaped moulds and left to set.
There we go.
Dessert made, it's on to the main. Thai red curry with sticky coconut rice.
I don't think that's complicated. I can make that very easy, unless they've made the paste, the red Thai curry paste themselves.
Well, that's the plan. Wish them luck. For the paste, they start by frying spices before blending with lemongrass, garlic, chilies, lime juice and sugar. Bit pungent by any chance?
Not so spicy.
Ricky cooks off the raw chicken with the spicy Thai paste and coconut milk. You sure that's right?
Oh, no.
What? What?
Stir chicken until chicken is fully cooked, then add the coconut milk.
Ricky!
Oh, Ricky!
This is so bad.
You said it.
We have £1,000 we could be winning, Ricky.
Oh, can you help me, please?
They said this is just a bit of fun to you, isn't it?
Hold this. This is so funny.
I'm not sure Becca thinks so.
This is a completely new experience and one that I'm regretting, slowly.
Once the chicken is cooked through correctly, the spicy coconutty sauce is added for a second time, along with chicken stock and peppers. And it's left to simmer.
Forgive me?
No.
You do?
No, I don't. Excuse you annoyed me.
I'm sorry.
All right, let's carry on.
Forgiven.
You old charmer. Back on track, it's time for the starter. Duck leg with a homemade plum sauce.
Not very adventurous.
First off, Becca cuts up the plums.
I've got a lot of confidence in this one.
Plus, I'm not doing anything.
plus, Ricky's not touching it, so, yeah, that's a bonus.
Orange juice and sugar are added, along with red wine and beef stock. The duck will be cooked when the guests arrive.
Woohoo!
All right.
After a quick change...
You look lovely, by the way.
Oh, thank you, my darling.
Sean and Tim are first at the door.
Hello and welcome. Hello.
Followed by straight-talking Joy and Jerry.
Oh, not today, thanks.
Oh, once an entertainer.
Come on in. You look all right. Welcome to work.
What about me?
I was talking to you. She got in the way.
This is our first dinner party, so we've never actually done this together. And...
No sympathy for beginners. If it's crap, I'll tell you.
How supportive! And with nerves in the air, the debutante chefs serve up the starter.
We have to taste it.
No,
we have to taste it before you.
Well, no, if it's cooked, it's cooked.
Yeah, but we have
you
to
can
taste
see it.
Okay.
You'll taste it in a second, Ricky. It's duck leg in homemade plum sauce. Over to Joy.
I don't like the plums very much. No. I'm sorry.
Are they too sweet?
They're just sort of... It's just... I don't know actually what you've done with it, but it just tastes like you've cut plums up and maybe boiled them and put them on the plate.
Joy is a bit of a...
She's a bit critical.
Yeah, she's just kind of... Don't like this.
She didn't really say it in a nice way as well.
No.
It upset me a little bit, especially because it's our first time cooking together.
And she knew that.
If I don't like something, I've got to say, I'm not going to pretend that I like it. I can't do it.
At the table, talk turns to romance.
Jerry, what's the most romantic thing you've ever done for Joy?
Well, he thought he was really, really done the business. Oh, yeah. Bought me a flying lesson. And I opened it and I said, I've already done one. And he said, well, I thought you might want to do another one. Why? Why? I've got my money back.
I think Joy's one of them that's like, if he gets her like a silver necklace, she'll want gold.
Yeah.
If he gets her gold, she'll want diamonds.
It's never good enough.
No.
Yeah.
Tim's much more romantic for me.
A few years ago, I wrote a song for Sian. I've got it all set up and wrote the lyrics. We sit down, I start playing to see if she's noticed or starts listening to it, because, you know, clearly the lyrics were about her. Sian's response was, yeah, can you turn that off?
I find it uncomfortable. I find it, if the attention is on me, I don't like it very much.
Some people just don't like that. I'm sure there are lots of people that think we're very cringy.
Yeah.
Never.
So what's the most romantic thing that you've ever done for Becca?
You sang to me. You sang You Look Wonderful Tonight.
Aww. Come on, give us a little belt.
Oh, please don't.
It's late in the evening.
Oh, good heavens.
She's wondering what clothes to wear.
I am getting a little bit irritated with all the lovey-dovey stuff. I just find it a bit irritating. I mean, I just think...
You look wonderful tonight. We were like it when we first got together.
Yeah, but not with really in company.
We used to have a grope in the aisle at Sainsbury's.
Ew! In the kitchen, Ricky puts the finishing touches to the main. Well, it looks hot, but is it spicy enough? Thai red curry with sticky coconut rice.
Right, so who did what? Is it a joint effort or is somebody dominant in the kitchen? And
well, this is mostly Ricky's work.
Yeah.
Ricky's made this before. You were a bit controlling in the kitchen. Had a bit of troubles.
Give us a gory detail.
Did he get a bit excitable?
You could say that. Yeah. How did you
guess that?
How did I guess?
How does everyone like it? How is it?
Lovely.
Nice.
Yeah. Nice. Good. Yeah. Right level of spice.
I could probably go a bit hotter.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, just a tad.
Yeah. Okay.
I could. I like spices.
Can I use that spoon?
Yes, go ahead. We can replace that.
The sauce was too runny. It was almost like a soup. I literally had to use my dessert spoon because you couldn't pick it up any other way. And the rice was overcooked. It was all sticky and it was all stuck together and it was cold.
Well, it is meant to be sticky rice. Back at the table, it's confession time.
He can actually play a tune with his farts.
It's not irritating, that's a musical talent.
If you heard him, you would actually say that was.
That's a man's prerogative.
What's the tune?
Any tune. Melody together.
Don't you dare. He's so embarrassing. He really is embarrassing. Yes, you are.
I'm not.
You always do it in public and then he walks away and looks at me.
I think Jerry's got a lovely heart. He's very, very kind-hearted and sweet.
Yeah.
And he doesn't want to offend anybody.
No, really nice guy.
Joy that can do that for him.
Ricky and Becca need dessert to be a knockout if they're to be in with the chance of winning the grand. Oopsie. Here it is, heart-shaped vanilla panna cotta and a love challenge for Sian.
Sian, we have nominated you because we thought that...
Well, Tim's such a romantic. As well.
That we thought that you would have to do something romantic for Tim.
OK. Tim?
On?
You're worried, aren't you?
It's been 25 years.
I can't sing, so I'm going to sing.
Not you two.
You're going to sing?
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine.
Taxi!
I chose to sing to you because I thought you'd like that. And
did it melt your heart?
It did, yeah. Did it melt yours?
It melted my dessert.
The dessert was the best thing of the whole meal.
Yeah, I would second that.
I think everyone enjoyed themselves, so what if two things didn't go down as planned, but that's
but
life.
I mean, yeah, and you laugh about it, and yeah, we really enjoy it. A lot of laughs, and that's what counts.
I think we're definitely in a chance to win.
We loved the starter and the pud, but the main wasn't quite up to scratch, so for that, we're going to give Ricky and Becca 16.
Because they're really not experienced enough to hold a dinner party, in our opinion, and I really didn't like the starter, we're going to give Ricky and Becca a 13.
So, a night of romance doesn't really melt any hearts, leaving beginners Ricky and Becca in last place with 29. Coming up, tears at the table.
I just can't eat now.
I did really, really feel uncomfortable.
And the winners are revealed. It's the final day in North London, and Sian and Tim's turn to host. And they can expect more of the same from Joy and Jerry tonight.
I like to think I'm an honest person, and I wouldn't say I like something if I don't.
Yesterday, she...
Yeah, she brought the mood down a little bit. I don't know what happened. She just was more negative.
If I upset somebody, then I'm sorry about that, but that's the way it is.
Tim and Sian are such a nice couple. I hope she's not...
Yeah, I hope she doesn't ruin
their... Not critical, just for the sake of it.
I love Joy's honesty, and the fact that if she said no, this tastes like rubbish, then that's great. I've got fair, I've got accurate and honest feedback.
Well, let's see what she makes of your main course: Thai barbecue lamb.
It's your worst nightmare.
I don't eat lamb. I hate lamb in any shape or form, and I was praying that nobody was going to cook lamb.
Joy's nightmare meat is coated with a homemade marinade of Thai herbs and spices.
Can you get the salt that's there in front of me?
Yep.
And just give it a sprinkle over.
OK. More?
Keep going. Not... Keep... Yeah, like that. Lovely, thank you. That's enough.
The very well-salted lamb is left to rest, and it's on to dessert. Mango and raspberry frozen yoghurt.
I wouldn't have thought that would be a dessert so much, but it depends how they may present it.
Get on with it.
Into the mixer go frozen mango pieces, yoghurt, mint and honey.
I think they're going to love this. And if they don't, I'll have some for later.
A
once blitzed, Tim makes up the summer fruits version.
I'd like to get it as smooth as possible. Just leave it. Get your hand off of there. Have faith in the mixer. That'll do. Needs a bit more.
No, I like that. That's good.
The yoghurt blends are popped into the fridge to set, so it's onto the starter. Vietnamese summer rolls with tom yum soup.
That sounds yum yum.
Yeah.
Tom yum?
Yeah.
Little safety tip with this one is that it needs hot water. It doesn't need to be boiling hot water. If you take this over to the kettle and then walk across the kitchen, you're going to get it to slop around all over the place. It's going to go down, you're going to get burnt. So you take the hot water to the pan.
Thanks for that, Tim. The rice paper sheets are dampened with the hot water, and then a mixture of cooked prawns, noodles and fresh vegetables are wrapped in the sheets.
So that's what it sort of looks like. Well, it does look like that, actually, because I just made it.
They're popped in to chill and will be served with a tom yum soup tonight. That's the food out of the way. Time for a quick change before their guests arrive.
Right, come on then, Tim. Let's get this show on the road.
Anything left to do?
Change your shirt again. First in, it's a scrubbed-up Joy and Jerry.
Joy, Jerry, coming in.
How are you?
Knock, knock.
Well, Tim, nice to see you, mate. Take care.
Nice to see you. Come on, just go straight through there.
And here are Ricky and Becca.
Hello.
Hi, Ricky, you all right?
Delightful.
Just checking.
Don't do on the other end.
While the hosts get on with the starter, Ricky and Jerry have a route around their bedroom.
Whoa! Marathon.
There's millions of them.
So who do you think they are?
I reckon Sean's. Because Tim would look too funny running.
Yeah.
Have you ever done one?
Oh, I couldn't do
that. Joy?
Not now. No, she's done parachute jumps.
Yeah?
Unfortunately, she came back to Earth all right. if she hears this, I'm going to be in deep
Stop there! Time for the food, I think. Vietnamese summer rolls and tom yum soup.
I actually quite like the spice.
Do you?
It's a good level.
Soup is perfect, absolutely beautiful.
The tom yum soup I really, really enjoyed. The only criticism I've got is they should have taken the towels off the prawns.
The soup for me was a little bit plain, actually. I had a bit of spice, but the summer rolls made up for it totally. I thought they were fantastic.
Jerry and I, we had a little look upstairs. We saw all these medals.
Whose do you think they are?
Well, we both said you. And then I said, well, they could be Tim's, though. And then...
I said they could be Tim's. I can't. Because I know I like the fire brigade, but I couldn't imagine Tim running. I don't know. No, not in a bad way.
They're my medals. I want to be buried with them. And I saved my race numbers as well.
I admire you.
Yeah. I'm going to make a burial shroud. Oh, I'm not going to make it, but I'm hoping somebody else will make a burial shroud out of my numbers and wrap me in them.
Ah, nice upbeat dinner party chat.
Yeah. So that's my little talent.
Well, me and Ricky have a talent together. We're dancers.
What sort of dance?
Sirok dance.
Oh, yes!
Jive, blues.
Could you give us a bit of a demonstration?
We can dance, but first we kiss.
Of course you do!
Very nice.
I'm still quite irritated with Ricky and Becca with the touchy-feely bits and all that. I really don't think it's necessary.
Yeah, I have to say, it's better than your cooking, love.
Charming!
I hadn't finished, and your cooking is lovely.
Well saved. Time to tackle the next course. After a quick sizzle on the barbecue...
Lovely, chubbly!
The main course is ready. Thai barbecue lamb. Good luck, Joy.
Joy, you look a bit... perturbed about this. Is lamb not your favourite?
Even the smell of it makes me gag.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Do you want us to open it? Do you want us to open the door?
Yeah, I'm really, really sorry, Sean.
No, what's the matter? Because we don't want to upset anybody. Oh, don't cry.
I just don't eat. I just can't eat.
Is it because it's lamb?
I just can't eat lamb.
I did really, really feel uncomfortable. And I felt very difficult, and I was starting to feel upset myself.
I just don't eat lamb.
You've said.
I think Joy definitely a massive drama queen, and also a bit of a diva. Everything, she just wants everything her way. If she don't like it, she don't care.
Can everybody just tuck in? I've got a bit of chicken in the fridge. Is that okay?
Sean.
If you don't mind.
Don't worry about it. But don't let this go cold, everybody, please. Yes. Please enjoy your meal.
I just find they're both a little bit kind of come across rude this evening and a bit.
Definitely. Rude would be the word, I think.
Really? I had a little bit of chicken.
Give me a cuddle.
I'll be leaving with a bitter taste in my mouth, really, and that's not from Tim or Sean's food. That's from Jerry and Joy's attitude, really.
Yeah, I completely agree.
What do you think, Jerry? It's all right, be honest. I don't mind. It's not the end of the world, honestly. It's just food.
It's going to sound really bad if I say it's not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, it does sound bad.
Nothing against your cooking at all.
I don't know if he liked it or not, but he was very polite.
Yeah, he did.
Which is actually worse than actually saying, no, I really don't like this, I wouldn't eat it. I'd rather the other reaction, because we could have dealt with that.
The barbecued lamb was tasty, but a little bit dry and chewy for myself.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I just really enjoyed it. I really loved it, all the rice and the salad. It was good for me.
Great.
At least someone's happy. Back in the kitchen, Sean and Tim have one last chance to impress. And here it is, mango and raspberry frozen yoghurt.
It's really nice. Especially after quite a big main, it's quite nice to have, like, a light, refreshing... Yeah, it's really lovely. Yeah.
Very nice. It is very nice. The top's a little bit tart. But
have you had maple syrup?
No, I don't really like maple syrup.
Not that as well.
No, I've got some lamb in the freezer.
Get stuffed.
The frozen yogurt, I thought not the most adventurous
it was a bit plain. There was just a bit of fruit.
But quite refreshing.
Perhaps Tim will have better luck impressing his guests with the little ditty he's written.
Lover or hater, Joy cooks alligator. Whilst Jerry the hippie is cool.
Tim's definitely got a sense of humour. Very strong wit.
We've known that Tim had a sense of humour since day one, as soon as we met him as well.
And as soon as we saw his outfit to begin with.
A cute couple, really. They're all touchy and feely. But Ricky can't juggle those balls. We pulled out all the stops tonight, but I do think the competition's pretty stiff, so it's anybody's game.
Well, actually, it's just between you two and Joy and Jerry, who currently lead with 32.
Unfortunately, the food wasn't as good as the hosting skills. For that reason, we're giving them a 15.
So tonight, I feel like they've been really good hosts. They've done really well. Starter and mains. Dessert let them down a little bit. So overall, we're going to give them a...
Hold it! It's the final host's job to reveal the winner.
OK, everybody, this is it! Woo! Ooh, in third place, Ricky and Becca. OK, well, it's between you two and us two, so... In second place... Oh,
hey!
Sean and Tim! So, first Joy and Jerry!
Ricky and Becca scored 16, making Joy and Jerry the winners by 1 point.
Without you doing it, there's no chance I could have done anything like that, and you deserve it all. There you go, darling.
Well, I have it all then. Thank you very much.
I thought you had it in the bag, love.
Oh. Well, I think we were robbed. We came second, we was robbed, I think.
We
pulled out all the stops, we was robbed.
For more on Come Down With Me, head to the Channel 4 website.
There's always got to be a winner and everyone's got their different decisions.
And at least Joy and Cherry can go and have a lovely holiday with it.
Yeah.
Or buy a house up north.
Let's sacrifice a lamb. Joy! Oh.
You can't leave it alone.
Made in Chelsea, made in Judy, quote of the week. And tonight it's bobsleigh plus massive surprise. The jump continues live from 8 o'clock. Simpsons next. Spare kidney, anyone? Oh yeah, almost forgot.